Hey, I'm Shoshana Chaim, co-host of the Plant Trainers Podcast, helping you improve your quality of life through nutrition and fitness. And today we are talking about how to get children to eat their mushrooms. Seven ways to get children to eat their mushrooms. So mushrooms are kind of those icky, slimy things that sometimes we as adults don't even like, and then we find that our kids don't like them, and of course they must eat their mushrooms. So how are we going to get them to eat it? Well, number one is take them to market, right? Take them to the grocery store, take them to the market, have them look at the different kinds of mushrooms, choose the ones that they might be able to try or touch or feel or smell. There's all different kinds of mushrooms. There's those tiny, tiny little ones that have like those little stems and cluster up. There's the big portobello mushroom one. There's the little button mushrooms. Hey, did you know that portobello mushrooms are actually those button mushrooms, just they've been allowed to grow longer? There's all kinds of mushrooms out there. So get your children choosing them because they will be more likely to eat them. Bring them home and cook with your children too. Let them cut them up. It's a really great first cutting object or food for children because it's not very hard and a little bit safer. Be careful with what kind of knife and definitely supervise them. But let them cut it up. Let them throw it in the pan. Let them throw it in the pot. Try to get them to eat them because they've made them. Number three is try all different kinds of varieties. Like I talked about before at the market, when they're actually choosing what they think they're gonna like, buy a whole bunch. Each week, come home with a different one and let them try a different kind of mushroom. Number four, just hide it, right? Hide it. Puree it in a soup. Cut it really, really small and mix it with lentils when you're making taco or burrito meat. Whatever you need to do to get them in them, because once their palate starts to get used to it, once they're used to that texture, they're more likely to eat it in bigger chunks as well. Number five, let them play with their food. Hello, little mushroom, how are you today? Let them talk, let them play with their food. You know, as long as you're not eating, you know, at some kind of fancy restaurant with 1800 forks and knives all around you, let kids have a little bit of fun. If they are more likely to eat it that way, then isn't that worth it in the end? I think so. Number six, something that has worked in our house is send them to somebody else's house and let them eat them there. My daughter came home saying, I ate mushrooms for dinner and they had just steamed them and she loved them. And then I was able to replicate that and do the same thing. So let them eat things in other places when they don't have the pressure of the parents looking down on them, making sure that they eat them all the time. And number seven is cut the pressure, like I just said. Stop yelling, maybe even just give up and accept the fact that they are not going to eat those mushrooms. When they see that you've given up, they might be more willing to take them. And you know what, if they don't eat mushrooms today, well, they might eat them tomorrow, or they might eat them in a week, or they might eat them in a month. Chances are you probably didn't eat your mushrooms either, and you kind of turned out okay. Or maybe you really did turn out okay. I'm sure you did. I love you. Anyway, we are talking all about mushrooms. Check out the Plant Trainers Podcast number 277, where we talk all about mushrooms and you get all the scoop. So we shall see you there. And if you don't know where to find that, you could find it at Instagram, linked in our bio. You could find it on Stitcher. You could find it on Spotify. You could find it on Apple Podcasts. The Plant Trainers Podcast number 277. See you there.